Ready? All right, so this is our pregnancy workout. This is the workout that Nina has been doing her entire pregnancy, and everything has gone very well. So we're gonna do a lot of different stuff, but your circulation will be good, your energy will be good, your baby will flow. All right, now we go arm circles. Do about 20 seconds each exercise. Go through this, memorize this, do it on your own, write down the ones you like, anything you want to take from it, do that.
I'm just clarifying.
Sure.
I'll do big ones and I'll do these little
ones. Next, we'll go hips. So it's all circles first. We go neck circles, we go shoulder circles, we go hip circles, then we'll work the feet circles. Big circle. Show us some sexy moves, Nina.
Oh, gosh. So I do this every morning. I don't do it in the exact same order Matt does, but I do this every morning because I started doing it and felt really good.
On your tippy toes, tippy toes. So we want to get blood through every joint to keep the circulation good. So all this mobility stuff does that. It oxygenates the whole body. Lift up as high as you can on those tippy toes. Alright, toes up like this. Yep, this was the intense workout music.
It was called workout, but that's what I'm gonna do.
Alright, turn those feet in. Turn them in. All right, now show us hip swings. Go against the wall. That's it, go. You're internally rotating your foot. You're externally rotating your foot. Internally rotating, externally rotating. This left foot is squared up because you're working your ankle mobility when you turn. All right, other side, go. Rocker, look in the camera and say hi. All right, front to back hip swings. Getting the hips opened up. All right, Nina, tell us about pregnancy. What are some of your top pregnancy tips?
Well, it depends on what your goal is. That's a broad question, but one thing I will say is...
Switch sides.
One thing I'll say is as you get further along, your body produces more of this hormone called relaxin, which makes your muscles literally relax. So as I started doing this, later and later in the pregnancy, you notice like more things would like fall into place or snap and in good ways. So it's really good in the third trimester.
Walking, hugging knee.
Or just in general, just I think stretching, moving, mobility is like so important the further along you get.
What can you tell us about blood sugar and pregnancy?
A lot.
Any stories you want to share?
So I did not do the glucose tolerance test. If you're pregnant, you either know what that is or you'll be fine.
High and what?
And I instead pricked my finger 4 times a day for 2 weeks because that's the protocol if you don't do that. And I just got really into it. I found it really interesting what affects your blood sugar in certain ways. And I know pricking fingers not for everybody, but for me, I thought it was really interesting. For me, I thought it was really interesting to observe how certain things will, I passed the test, let me just say. I passed the test so I don't have gestational diabetes, but I still felt like when you eat certain things, I would see my blood sugar go up quite a bit. So I was like, that's interesting.
Quad sugar.
I kind of found it more beneficial than just doing a one-time test to keep track of it over time. Because I think some people might pass the test and still be borderline and have some issues, or not issues, but undesirable blood spikes, let's say. So I've found it fun and beneficial to keep track of it basically this whole time.
So what kind of meals should people be eating if they're worried about spiking their blood sugar and they want to keep level blood sugar and still feel good and energetic? What's tasty that they can still eat?
Lower carb, but still keeping it clean. Don't go to those like cheap, you know, processed stuff. Lower carb, and when you do eat carb, it should be like fruit, peanut butter.
Feed super well.
Fruit, peanut butter. And then there's like a lot of tricks. There's this Instagram I really like called Glucose Goddess. She talks a lot about the order in which you eat things. So if you're gonna eat carbs, if you're gonna go for a sugary treat, have some protein and fat first. That's huge.
All right, go to one knee.
You can basically eat the same thing and have way less of a spike.
There's a blue pad right there.
Oh, thank you. You can eat the same thing and have way less of a spike if you have some fat and some carbs first.
Face the camera. Alright, twist. Or no, we can't twist. Side bend. Pregnant people cannot twist in their workouts, obviously.
Yes, basically from the beginning, you should start avoiding that. But you can twist open. You can't twist. Just think of it like if you feel like you're compressing your baby with what you're doing, that's not the right way. But if you're opening up, that's fine.
Turning up in here. Sometimes just all this movement. So go up and down there, Nina. Kind of go down, you know, with your right hand down.
Oh, like this?
Yep, and then rotate it. Yep.
I do this one a little differently.
Is there any tea people can drink while they're pregnant?
Well, I was going to say.
What is it?
That's kind of later because let me start with the first trimester.
Lift your back knee.
First trimester. You don't want to drink this tea I'm going to talk about. You should wait till later, 24 weeks. But the first trimester, that was my worst. Second, third's been a breeze. First was tough. I got a lot of morning sickness. And we like to keep things as holistic or natural as possible. So lots of ginger chews. Lots of, that's when I did eat a lot of carbs. Because, like, the bready type of things that just make your nausea go away. But yeah, ginger's big. There's some stuff you can find on Amazon. They're called pregnancy pops. They've got a few things in it. And then I know people have had a lot of success with taking a small dose of Unisom and vitamin B12. Is that the beep?
Yeah. You did the side bend on this side?
No.
All right, side bend.
No.
We're gonna switch up the order that time.
So that's the first trimester. That's all I can really say. Other than that, you should be super careful with everything. I mean, your doctor will give you a list, but that's when you're like just being careful and trying to fight off the nausea you're going to feel until your placenta comes into play. Your body's running on hormones and you might feel pretty tired and crappy. All right, now I'm going to do the knee lift.
Yeah, the lizard.
And then starting the second trimester, this tea Matt's talking about is raspberry leaf tea, which I've been drinking every day. You kind of up the dosage. There's lots of stuff you can find online about the dosage, or there's like midwives I like to watch on YouTube.
All right, let's back this up and get you on the hands and knees.
Come on, Michael.
Back up. Put your hands and knees on here. Let's do hip circles. Rocco, you determined to be part of this video, huh?
But yeah, so raspberry leaf tea is, it tones your uterus. It's actually great for like menstrual cramps and periods and all that, but I hadn't heard of it until I became pregnant. Really great for prepping your uterus for pregnancy. There are studies they've done where they've seen how women who drink raspberry leaf tea, bleed less in labor. It just generally is a little quicker, a little easier. So it's kind of tasty, so why not? That's something I've been drinking for a while now.
All right, put one hand behind your head and twist open. All right, how can you sleep well if you're pregnant?
Well, one thing I'll say is you should prioritize it. A lot of women get insomnia, and I think you should do whatever is necessary to get good sleep, because I think it affects everything else, including your blood sugar, which I was talking about. Stress and bad sleep, if you are, again, interested in all that blood sugar stuff, that will spike your blood sugar for the whole day. So just relaxing is important. Tons of magnesium is what's helped me. I mean, like, Matt can tell you about the side effects of too much. I've not had any, no matter how much I seem to up it orally. Because I think in pregnancy, you need a lot more. So magnesium at night. There's a tincture you can get called Skullcap. That is really helpful for insomnia and totally safe in pregnancy.
Skullcap helps you sleep.
Yes. That was recommended to me by a midwife for if you have insomnia in pregnancy. And then just figure out why you're not having good sleep, because if it's because you're uncomfortable, that could be more like, you know, that could almost be more of a mobility issue. If you're having a lot of aches and pains, I know that keeps a lot of pregnant women up, and for that, I'd recommend this.
Is there any special kind of magnesium that you would use to relax your body?
We've tested a bunch, and that magnesium glycinate.
Magnesium glycinate.
Yeah, so you just look in the back of the bottle for where, it'll tell you where it comes from. I didn't know this, but there's tons of different kinds of magnesium.
Just apply, bring that baby towards the ceiling.
And so,
that one on your core. Mm-hmm. Pressing your belly button towards the ceiling when you're in a plank is a good cue. So these planks are really important. Go to your side plank. These planks are really important to stabilize all your core muscles. What you don't want to do is like crunching and movement type ab exercises that compress your belly. You want to find these plank variations where your spine is elongated and it's just stability. Your spine stays in a neutral posture and you're strengthening up all those ab pelvic muscles. This is gotta be really good for later on in pregnancy, like right now. Nina has no issues. She has no back pain, she has no joint pain, she has no hip pain, because all these muscles are strong from doing all these planks. I like something called magnesium chloride. This is similar to Epsom salt, but much more potent. I like to soak my feet in it.
Yeah, so that's for, I'll do that too in the baths. But orally, magnesium glycinate seems to be good. And then I will have a bath at least a few times a week.
Do both feet. Go.
With what Matt's talking about, the magnesium chloride. Do you want me to hold up or do we open up?
Bring your feet towards each other. Really, yeah. Now, yeah. And now get your hips up and just hold them up.
Just hold.
Yeah, you want to just keep that tension engaged. Squeeze your booty here. All right, back to the regular plank. Ready, set, go.
So on the topic of like things to help you not have pain, lots of stretching, this mobility, and then lots of walking. So I have not done much of like, I'll do little cardio workouts, but I haven't done much with that. I try to walk like an hour a day when the weather's nice and I can. I mean, just tons of walking. I think that helps with, I haven't had any swelling issues. I just think the walking, the circulation, the moving really helps not swell.
Is the sunlight, fresh air?
Yeah.
If you're lucky enough to not be pregnant when it's super hot outside?
Right, and if you are, you know, I have a walking treadmill in my house. I do that too when it's gross outside, so that works just the same.
Other side.
YouTube actually has videos that they're like YouTube walking videos where you kind of just step around. That's probably a good option. High volume, low intensity, getting the circulation up, getting your blood pumping in ways that are just kind of gentle and safe and mostly increase circulation and don't get too intense. We're gonna do a little bit of intensity here in a minute. All right, Bridge. I think the mobility exercises are really important, and then I think all these planks are really important.
Yeah, so that's for not having aches and pains, but I've geeked out on how to get the baby in the right position and all that kind of stuff. You've probably heard of a birth ball. What do you call it otherwise, like a stability ball?
Yeah. Regular plank.
Getting one of those, bouncing on those. This is for third trimester, this is for later, but bouncing on it, figure eights with your hips. These are all things that help get the baby engaged in your pelvis. A lot of you have probably heard of it. And then one thing I learned I did not know, a little tip, is when you are in the third trimester, you know, in the phase where you're trying to get, or even late second trimester, leaning forward a lot. We do a lot of this, you know, sitting kind of like this. You don't want your back rounded because the baby is going to round their back to whatever's round in you. You want that to be your belly. So you're gonna be leaning forward. You want the roundness here so the baby's in the right position. So I spend a lot of time thinking about that, you know, if you're at a desk job, just think about your posture a lot. It'll also help with back pain.
Other side. So I think the mobility and the plank stuff is probably the most important for you ladies doing this video. So if you think you've kind of done enough, I think we put the important stuff first here. So after we finish out these planks and this last bridge, we're gonna go into some exercise. We're gonna go into some light interval training to get the heart rate up. We're gonna do some breathing and some meditating. All right, back to that bridge.
Stretches.
And some stretches. But if you wanna stop after this bridge, that's a good kind of minimum. That's a good halfway. That's, you know, you did something, you got the minimum done. Because the rest of this workout might be more challenging for some people.
They could also skip to the stretches.
You could also skip to the stretches.
I'm big on the stretches.
Yeah, it's apparently very big on the stretches.
It helps with labor to be open down here. If you're somebody that thinks you have tight hips or tightness in your pelvis in any way,
all right.
Stretching is important.
So that's it there. Now let's go to push-ups, squats, and lunges.
So this is our more workout section, right?
Now we're going to get the heart rate up. Ready, set, go. Nina's going to show you how even a pregnant girl can do it.
They're baby push-ups, real baby push-ups.
That light range of motion is fine. It's all about just getting the blood pumping, getting the heart circulating, getting the regular health benefits from exercise that we normally get. All right, now squats. And when you do this stuff, it gets the energy out of your body. It helps you sleep deeper. And whatever you can do to get your sleep better, you're gonna recover better, your baby's gonna recover better, you're gonna heal, your body's gonna stay relaxed.
And from what I've read Iname's Guide to Childbirth, squats are also a big one for helping you prepare for labor. It's a good movement to do.
Lunges.
Lunges are just tough.
Wait a second. Tell us about your favorite books, your favorite resources.
Should I do one side?
I would alternate views.
Alternate. Okay, Iname's Guide to Childbirth was good if you're thinking about doing any kind of natural labor.
Ina May's Guide to Childbirth.
If you're not thinking of doing natural, it's not that helpful.
Push-ups.
There's a book called Real Foods for Pregnancy if you are interested in the learning more about the nutrition side. Real Foods for Pregnancy, Lily Nichols, I believe. But that's definitely the title, so you'll see it. That's a great one for diet and supplements and just telling you what you know should and shouldn't be eating.
Any podcasts for pregnancy?
Yeah, so my favorite
squats.
Yeah, got it. My favorite resource has actually been YouTube. the couple midwives I really love and trust on there. I just watch all their videos. I learned so much. I'm talking in the mirror. One is named, her name's Midwife Kyra, which she goes by Cajun Stork. And the other one is Bridget Taylor. She's a birth doula. They're both really great. Lots of videos. I mean, any topic you're like interested in learning about, just pull up their name and whatever the topic is on YouTube. Learned a ton from that. Took some notes.
Go ahead and repeat those names again.
Midwife Kyra, but she goes by Cajun Stork, and Bridget Taylor, who's a doula.
Push-ups.
And just in general, if you're like, I don't know much about whatever topic, putting it in on Google and finding like a doctor or midwife who has, you know, a lot of views, I'll watch a couple different people's opinions on it, you can learn really quickly whatever it is you want to know. Haven't found many podcasts, but there's a hypnobirthing podcast that was interesting. Again, if you're into the more natural birth.
Was.
And there's this British one I like called Is It Normal? And it's just kind of funny and interesting. But the things our bodies do when we're pregnant. So that one's enjoyable, kind of short.
Any Instagram or TikToks?
Not really. I just follow the people I kind of mentioned on Instagram and such. There's that one I had you follow for birth partners, and that could be interesting if you're wanting to get your husband involved or your partner in any way. There's an Instagram called, I think it's just called, you remember it? Can't remember the name. Something Birth Partners. But you could look that up, Birth Partners, on Instagram, and they've got some good videos, quick stuff you can send your partner that they can watch.
All right, step ups, intervals.
Can you grab weights or no?
Yeah, they're down there. Five. So this part is the interval. So whatever you can do safely to get your heart rate up. So this is safely.
I'd rather the fives. Hold on. I didn't see him. All right.
Hold on. There's four to the space. Ready, set, go. So any exercise that you can do to get your heart rate up here. This is all about just heart rate. Maybe stepping up on a chair is not the safest thing, so it could potentially be a little bit safer. But we've got like a sprint bike. You could do like incline treadmill walking. The idea is to get yourself out of breath and then catch your breath. All right, rest. Rest for 20 seconds.
Well, I'm going to show really quick. One I like, I use a Bozu. We're not doing it because not everybody has it, but if you have your foot on a Bozu or something incline, I like doing this. This is a good one. And then switching. You have something you can do that with. My back?
Yeah.
And your step up doesn't have to be this high. If you have stairs or just like a little step, I just find that motion of stepping up, pressing something over your head, it's good enough to get the heart rate going.
And when it comes to interval training, it's not important that you perform something. It's important that you just, that your body perceives that it was hard rest so that you just get out of breath.
Yeah.
And your body gets out of breath. That's where the health benefits come from. Next thing I wanted to ask Nina, so you see how she's breathing kind of heavy, or at least heavy enough for what we want here. Next thing I wanted to ask you was, like, walk through your daily routine. So we got supplements, we got just, how does your day go? Go.
Prenatal in the morning.
When did you start taking prenatal?
3 months before we were gonna try to have a baby. And that is because that'll help you. So especially in the first trimester, I was talking about that morning sickness. You don't know what you're gonna be able to put down. I couldn't touch salmon, and that was a big superfood prior.
Oh, that was.
So the best thing you can do for your baby and for your body to prevent the possibility of miscarriage or just have everything go as smoothly as possible is to have those things your body needs when it's pregnant already stored up in your body before you get pregnant. It takes about 3 months. So I took prenatals for 3 months before I even got pregnant.
All right, so the fourth?
Yeah. And so I take that in the morning, some vitamin D. Extra vitamin D is always good. And then midday, I'll take a magnesium potassium pill. So like I said, the more magnesium, the better. Fish oil.
All right, Russ. Yeah, I like fish oil for brain development and even just young kids in general. Lots of fish oil is probably really good to help their brain develop. I've always been a big fan of phosphatidylcholine. I think that can help out a lot.
That's a bad.
What else you take? Any B vitamins or that's in the prenatal?
Yeah.
This is 5. Yeah. But give us your routine. I mean, it's waking up, it's walking, we do collagen.
So I make breakfast, which for me is eggs, avocado, pumpkin seeds. I do the mobility. I take my vitamins and I go walk, usually for 45 minutes to an hour. And that's kind of my, gets me energized for the day, gets me going. And I'm a tutor, so I work more in the afternoon. So during the day, I'm like housework, cleaning up dishes, cooking. Which I think is really beneficial because, like I said, it keeps me moving. I'm not sitting. But if you're somebody that has to do an office job during the day, I say maybe get a birth ball you can sit on.
All right, last one.
Just think about your posture.
Last one here, go a little hard.
And get moving whenever you can. I'll take baths with the magnesium as often as I can.
Magnesium chloride.
That's in the afternoon. I'll do stretches at night, some pigeons, yeah.
All right, that's it. That's all the hard work. Now we just go to Nina's favorite stretches.
Yes. Okay, so in the morning what I do, because I don't do this harder workout every day, I do the walking, like I said, most of the time. I will do mobility followed by this. First thing I do, everything you want to do, the most important thing is that you're opening up your hips. So think about anything in this area. I mean, use your intuition, feel around. I've added stuff just by being in a position and feeling like, you know what? It would feel great if I did this or that. Then do it. You'll know what opens you up and what doesn't. I like this one to kind of get your psoas. If you have round ligament pain, I'm sure you'll hear about that from your doctor because it's the most common thing. This helps a lot. So that's lunge position, leaning forward till you feel that pull right here, lifting that arm up, really helps for round ligament. Then I'll come down into my lizard, hold here, you're pulsing your hips forward. You're gonna feel that inner thigh stretch. I like to come down to my elbows. I've always been a little more flexible. Don't feel like you have to do that. Wherever you feel that good stretch without it being painful, that's where you want to stay. And I take deep, slow breaths. I'm talking right now, but usually it's all about the deep exhales, deep breaths.
You know what? I bet they're wondering how close you are to your due date.
I am about 39-ish weeks, so 38 and a half, 39. I'm close, very, very close. So after you do that deep lunge like this, maybe come onto an elbow, just getting as deep as you can into it, whatever feels good. If you're gonna come up, we kind of already did this one in mobility, but I do like to lift up and open. So again, that's that twist that's opening, so that's okay. You don't want to twist or you're kind of crowding the baby. Then I'll lean back here and I'm gonna get a nice stretch to the back of the leg. I used to love a forward fold with the belly. You can't just do a full forward fold anymore. This is the best way that I've found to stretch your hamstrings. I'll do a ankle circle, get all this. And then one I really like when you get closer like me to open up your hips more, I'm gonna take this back foot, turn it inward and sit down, come up and down. This is opening your hips from a slightly different angle. Somebody told me this one. It might've been my pelvic floor therapist. Another thing I recommend, seeing a pelvic floor therapist if you can. Now I'm just gonna do the other side. So standing, press forward reaches that round ligament stretch. Hold it longer than I am if you have that round ligament pain. I did have a little bit of that in my second trimester and this really helped. Deep breaths. And then I'm gonna do the same thing as before. Come down into the lizard. maybe elbows, whatever you do on the other side.
We're getting some breathing exercises here in a second.
Come back, do that hamstring stretch, circle with the ankle. And then I'm going to do that side, so turning the foot in, sitting down, and coming up. I'm going to do pigeon over there. And if you can do this throughout the day, for a couple minutes, malasana squat, awesome to open up the hips. So just sit in it, hold, sway. You want your heels to be on the ground. If they're up like this, bring your feet wider. See if you can get them on the ground. You can also use a block. Then feet wide, fold over. And so notice like everything I did was like about the hips. Now I'm going to do that pigeon.
So if you have a couch maybe?
Yeah, I do this on my couch at home.
I like going foot first, yeah.
You have to kind of adjust because the belly will start to be in your way. Just gonna push your hips back, lean forward, and that's when I'll feel it. And then just hold.
Alright, what else? Any nighttime routines?
You know what I didn't mention? This is not a nighttime routine, but you'll get this like midday fatigue where you'll need a nap essentially. And especially for me because I tutor in the afternoon, so I need to like around 3 or 4 o'clock I need that energy again and get back going. I'm about to go to work. Yoga Nidra has been huge. It's a version of non-sleep deep rest. That's what NSDR.
You can YouTube search NSDR or Yoga Nidra, N-I-D-R-A. It's like a guided power nap. So you lie on your back and just really relax your nervous system, which for Nina, she had to tutor in the afternoons and she was getting exhausted like late day. So when she started doing these Yoga Nidra power naps for 10 minutes, 15, maybe 20 if you can, she was able to like really have a lot more energy in those tutoring sessions.
Yeah, and I mean, if you have kids at home that you have to come home to, maybe you're pregnant and you have other kids, or just anything where you don't want to feel so tired at 4 o'clock, huge.
Lie on your back. All right, now we're gonna breathe a little bit, then we're gonna meditate and talk to the baby.
Okay, but lie on your side. Can't lie in the back very much.
Oh, really? Because I was going to be doing one of those arm exercises. All right. Well, while you're lying on your side, hopefully your dog's not in your way.
Rocco, he's a ham. He loves to be in front of the camera.
All right. So first, start off with some breathing. So I want you to do a longer inhale than exhale. So do like an 8-second inhale and a 4-second exhale. 8 seconds in, 4 seconds out. Rocco can't resist. Inhale for 8 seconds. So now close your eyes and start to get into your body. What we're doing is we're filling your body with oxygen. We're oxygenating your blood. When you inhale more than you exhale, you fill your body up with energy. Relaxed breath, smooth. Notice where the breath is going in your lungs. Notice your lungs expanding at the top of your chest. Notice your lungs breathe. Normally it's the bottom of your chest, but maybe now you'll breathe some oxygen into the baby as you inhale into your belly. 8 seconds in, 4 seconds out. We'll do a few more of these. Relaxing your nervous system, your jaw, your shoulders, your hands, your feet. And now we're going to flip it. So now we're going to inhale for 4 seconds. We're going to exhale for 8 seconds. This is what we do when we want to tell the body it's safe. The body is relaxed. The body is safe. We don't need oxygen because everything is safe. And that's when your nervous system really starts to relax. Start to release any tension in your jaw, your neck, your shoulders. One thing I learned about meditation from traveling around the world and experiencing different practices is that the power of intention, if you tell your brain, if you tell your nervous system, if you tell your body to relax and you set that intention, that it has an effect. So tell your baby, baby, you're safe. Everything is calm and relaxed. 4 seconds inhaling, 8 seconds exhaling. Think about all the muscles around your belly, around your hips, sides of your thighs, the inside of your legs. And now just go into regular breathing. So start to get your brain inside of your body now. Just float around. Body feels heavy, soft, and relaxed. And then bring your attention inside of your belly to your baby. And just whisper some sweet thoughts to your baby. Tell him how safe it's going to be. Tell him how much you love him or her. We're having a boy. Set any intention. Relaxing your shoulders, your jaw, feeling the ground, your body against the ground. Tune in. Ask your baby a question. See if you can, if any thoughts pop into your head, that might be fun. And now you can lay here for as long as you want, and this concludes your pregnancy workout. Nina, any last words?
I hope whoever's watching this has a great pregnancy. Good luck.
Contact
Enjoy
Nina.
Enjoy it.
For all your pregnancy questions and needs, contact Nina Shelby Lovett at Nina Shelby on Instagram.
Nina Shelby Lovett.
All right, Nina, great job.